Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad, and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
भवान् भीष्मश्च कर्णश्च कृपश्च समितिञ्चयः अश्वत्थामाविकर्णश्च सौमदत्तिश्च वाचः ही सेज़ माय आर्मी इज डिस्क्राइबिंग they are yourself, Bhishma, Karna, Krupa, who is ever victorious in battle, even so Ashwatthama, Vikarna and the son of Somadatta. Now the Duryodhana is explaining his army. See the funny thing. He is talking to Drona. He could have easily said our army, not only he did not say our army, he is saying my army. Now he is saying, great warriors of my army, you. He is trying to possess even Drona as his servant. Please understand. See the peak of ego. When you discuss with somebody who is your teacher, who is now commander, you should say our army. He did not even bother to say our army. At least when you describe, you should have been little polite. He says, my warriors are first you. They are yourself, Bhavan, you. Bhishmascha, Bhishma, Karana, Krupa, and Ashwatthama, Vikarna, and the son of Somadatta. Now actually the fight starts between Karna and Bhishma. Because Karna expected, first he will be asked to lead the army. But Duryodhana chose Bhishma. And so the Karna takes a vow, till Bhishma is alive, I will not take my bow and fight in the army. Lot of internal conflicts. So Duryodhana now tries to feel secure by describing his army. Strength and valor arose from the feeling of being supported by his clan and the army around him. On the positive side, Duryodhana was an extremely generous friend. So he describes all the people like Drona, Bhishma, Karana, Krupa, Ashwatthama, Vikarna, and Somadatta. He goes on. Let me see in the next verses how further it describes. These are all actually description of the war scene, setting up the stage. Anye cha bhagavaha shura madarte tyakta jivita nana shastra prakarana sarve yuda sarve yuddha Visharataha. There are many other heroes who are prepared to lay down their lives for my sake. All of them are well equipped with the different kinds of weapons and all are experienced in military science. Now Duryodhana tries to explain his side, various. Anye cha bhagava suraha madarte tyakta jivitaha, means who are ready to sacrifice their life. Nana shastra prakaranaha sarve yuddha visharataha, who knows the whole logic and science of battle, science of military, and experienced in battle.
Discover the secrets of health and wealth in one package. For the first time, a two-day health and wealth workshop by Paramahamsa Nityananda. Healing for a range of ailments. Wipe out illness from body, mind and being. Awaken your body's natural intelligence and healing powers. Overcome stress and powerfully resolve your wealth-related conflicts. Discover discover the secrets of creating and celebrating wealth.
Let me tell you step by step how you build the patterns. First, the memory. Morning 7 o'clock, coffee is very nice. After 1 month, it becomes samskara, engram. Morning 7 o'clock, I should have coffee. After 1 year, it becomes muscle memory. Means morning 7 o'clock, if I don't get coffee, I will feel little low mood. I'll feel low, feel little irritated.
Dynamic interactive awareness sessions that reveal the secrets of a perfect health and having abundance in wealth.
I will have headache. That is bio memory. After 6-7 years or 10 years, really one day you are caught somewhere, you are not able to get coffee and having headache, rolling on the ground, that is DNA level. Now understand how the memory becomes samskara, engram, engram becomes pattern, pattern becomes muscle memory becomes bio memory becomes DNA level pattern.
Intense meditations and kriyas that holistically instill a transformed health and wealth consciousness in you. At Baroda, from March 24th to March 25th, 2012. Contact 91-851-11-25239.
He's trying to explain their commitments. The next verse also he continues. Aparyaptam tatasmakam balam bhishma abhirakshitam paryaptam dvitam etesham balam bhima abhirakshitam. This army of ours, now suddenly he is using the word ours. Asmakam. He is not using the word mama. He is using the word asmakam. After describing every name, now he feels the need for the word asmakam. He says, asmakam, this army of ours, protected by Bhishma, is invincible, whereas their army, protected by Bhima, is conquerable. He is trying to show his valor, saying, here is Bhishma, it is invincible. There only Bhima, we will conquer them. We will conquer them. So, he is using the word aparyaptam and paryaptam. Aparyaptam for his army, paryaptam for Bhima's army. Just all these verses show the confusion and the whole stage. He is just trying to boost his own morale by saying that the power of Gaurava army led by Bhishma was immense, whereas the Pandava army with Bhima as one of the commanders was limited in power. Duryodhana's reference to Bhima alongside Bhishma was due to the fear of the oath that Bhima has taken. Bhima had taken the oath to break Duryodhana's thigh and drink his blood to avenge the insult to Draupadi. Duryodhana knew that the only factor that could prevent it would be the protection of Bhishma. Nobody except Bhishma can face Bhima. So the fear of Duryodhana, he tries to equate Bhishma and Bhima. He is trying to improve the morale, boost the morale of the army. Today all these slokas or almost description of the war scene, setting the stage where Pandavas and Kauravas are standing and Duryodhana is describing this whole scene to the Drona and asking his consultation. This whole scene is described so vividly, you can't imagine. That is why I again and again insist, the whole Mahabharata is the truth as it happened. See, when you imagine, you can't go to such a minute details. With this logic and understanding, I tell you, you cannot imagine to these details if it is just imagination. It is really a happened story. Maybe in some places there are little poetic descriptions. That small poetic description or exaggeration cannot make the whole thing myth. No. The word Purana cannot be translated into myth. No. It is not even exaggeration. I should say that the ideas which can't be understood by your ordinary logic. That's all.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say, which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
When you see this detailed description, you can be very sure this cannot be a lie. And one more thing, if Vyasa is imagining the whole thing, at least at some points he should be inconsistent. Because 1 lakh verses, you cannot maintain consistency in 1 lakh verse if you are imagining. Try to write 100-page novel by imagination. You will see how many times you miss the names and miss the sites and become inconsistent. Here is a guy who is writing 1 lakh verses, 100,000 verses. There is no inconsistency. You can't maintain inconsistency if you are lying or imagining. Please understand. He is using all the names here. the Pandava side and Kaurava side. If he is just imagining and lying, after 10 verses he will suddenly miss one name at least. Because such a huge army, how can he maintain consistency? And the guy who is writing is Ganesha. He has made a condition: I will not rewrite, I will not repeat, I will not proofread. No, Ganesha has made all these conditions before writing. He says, you have to just continuously dictate, I'll pen down. If you give a gap, I'll stop and go away. And no rewriting, no proofreading, no gap. For my speed, you have to recite. So you don't even have a time to imagine and fit. Ganesha is ensuring only the truth is told. It's like a live video recording and audio recording. You can't change anything after that. I tell you, because it is live, recorded, and there is no inconsistency, and the sheer volume, length of the scripture, 100,000 couplets, I vouch the whole thing has happened. It is not imagination. No mind can imagine and maintain consistency for 100,000 slokas. It is impossible. It is impossible to maintain consistency in 100,000 slokas, 100,000 couplets. I tell you, even if it has happened, unless you have a divine vision, you will not be able to give such a precise details. Who is standing, which side? Understand, 18 crore people are there. At least there would have been 1 lakh leaders for 18 crore people. It's 10 crore one side and 8 crore other side. 10 crore is the Kaurava side and 8 crore is Pandava side. It is not 11-7. It is 10-8. I referred. It is 10-8. 10 Agroni in the Kaurava side. 8 Agroni in Pandava side. Understand? Even to repeat this information, I have to refer. And I missed once. Then, can you understand how difficult for Vyasa to imagine and maintain the consistency? No way. I tell you, it has happened. Vyasa is just recording. Vyasa is recording the whole scene. Otherwise, it is not possible to maintain the consistency. And you need to understand some of the funny things. When Duryodhana speaks here, certain grammar is maintained in the dialogue, certain slang. You will be shocked throughout the book, wherever Duryodhana speaks, the same slang is appearing. It is not a joke. To maintain the slang of the conversations of each character throughout the book. See, wherever Krishna speaks, the Krishna slang is maintained. The Dwarika Sanskrit. Wherever the Arjuna speaks, the Arjuna slang is maintained. Please understand, Arjuna and Krishna, both of them learned from the same Gurukul. But Krishna started living in Dwarka, so that the language was little different. So even the slangs of the conversation is maintained consistently throughout the 100,000 sutras. It's not a joke. The beginning of the book, when Bhishma speaks, how he speaks.
Discover the power of Kundalini Awakening at Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational program blessed personally by Rare Living Incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. What is Kundalini? Kundalini is the tremendous potential energy hidden inside every individual, which can be awakened through initiation by an enlightened master. Once awakened, Kundalini has the power to transform every area of your life and bring you health, wealth, success, joyful relationships and spiritual enlightenment. Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening at Kalpataru. Manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyanapetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
The words he uses, the grammar he uses. See, the Sanskrit is such, each one will have their own unique slang. The slang Bhishma uses in the beginning of the book and the end of the book, the Vishnu Sahasranama, both are maintained in the same slang. Understand? The beginning of the book, when the Bhishma takes a vow, the slang, the language, the conversation, the way, the style, the grammar he uses is the same when he is in the deathbed singing the glory of Vishnu. Visvam Vishnur Vashatkaro Bhuta Bhavyabhavat Prabhu. The Vishnu Sahasranama. You can't maintain a slang of each character's conversation throughout a huge epic. Understand, still now, Mahabharata is the largest epic. Still, nobody is able to break the record. I can say, Vyasa not only created one Guinness record of writing a longest epic poem, he has made one more Guinness record, the longest record which was not broken. The record which is not broken for a longest period. More than 5,000 years, still nobody is able to break the record. And it is impossible to write a book where even the conversations of the characters is consistent from beginning to end. No. That is why I tell you, it has happened. It is not just created. So with this, I end the satsang today. We'll continue the next verses in the next continuous days. Today is more a description, setting of the stage. Please understand, the whole first chapter, Krishna is not opening the mouth. Krishna opens his mouth only in the second chapter. He listens, listens, listens. He listens to the problem, understands the logic of the problem, understands how it is created. Then he is trying to solve.